The African Wildlife Consultative Forum is a week-long gathering of stakeholders from sub-Saharan African hunting countries who convene to discuss a wide range of wildlife management, conservation, and hunting priorities. The only event of its kind on the African continent and hosted by Safari Club International Foundation, the AWCF provides an opportunity for NGOs, professional hunting organizations, and ministry-level government officials to meet face-to-face to address common problems such as the scourge of poaching and human-wildlife conflict, as well as share information and solutions required for the unique challenges of managing Africa's wildlife. SCIF's envoy, George Pangetti, Foundation President Joe Hosmer, and Conservation Chair Dr. Al Mackey opened the 13th annual African Wildlife Consultative Forum in Hawassa, Ethiopia.
The purpose of the meeting, as you know, is the conservation of wildlife, sustainable benefits, and make life better for our peoples in Africa.
No one country can solve regional conservation problems alone. It requires interaction and cooperation at all levels, and I look forward to seeing what this meeting can do to perpetuate that goal.
As our countries are all connected, cooperation and communication are essential, especially with respect to the decisions that impact each other. Such decisions must be made on the very best available science and information. And SCI Foundation is dedicated to provide the best science and field data possible as a basis to guide future decision making.
One of the unique aspects of the AWCF is interaction with high-ranking government officials. Here, Ethiopia's Minister of Culture and Tourism, the Honorable Tadelik Deleko, addressed the delegates.
In Ethiopia, we are working with all stakeholders, governmental, non-governmental, private sectors, academicians, in general, the public at large, to mitigate the problem. Since this forum enables experience sharing opportunities among yourself, best practices will be gained to be used by different countries.
Representatives from 9 African governments reported on the status of wildlife in their countries. One of the major components of the AWCF is the perspective of the professional hunter. These boots-on-the-ground reports from various PH associations run the gamut geographically, from Ethiopia to South Africa, and provide a broad perspective on the benefits and challenges of sustainable use.
Ultimately, wildlife and wildlife habitat must provide a long-term benefit to local communities if it is to be conserved. This applies to all over Africa and, in fact, many parts of the world where wildlife and humans conflict is arising as populations and pressure on habitat and resources increasing. If this is not achieved, if it doesn't provide a benefit, it will most likely be exploited and will most likely be destroyed.
The 3 C's, conservation, communities, and commerce. Each one of those are dependent on the other. You will fail with your conservation objectives unless you've got community support. Unless you've got commerce to drive it and to fund it, the other two will fail.
The benefits of sustainable use hunting in Africa cannot be disputed, but still, problems remain. While always an issue, poaching has recently evolved from a problem to a full-fledged crisis, and the AWCF dealt directly with the question.
We are noticing gangs now getting into the protected areas. Sometimes gangs as big as 50 people, 40 people, and it will take a lot from government. As we speak, there is an operation in the Zambezi Valley to try and deal with the poachers that are currently in the area. We are being assisted by the Zimbabwe National Army, the Zimbabwe Republic Police, and the Air Force of Zimbabwe in terms of aerial coverage and in terms of manpower.
As you can see, there are still a lot of elephants in Africa. Whatever everybody says, there are more than roughly 500,000 elephants in Africa. Yesterday we were talking about the lions. There's no comparison between lions and elephants if you look at just population numbers. As you can see also, West Africa, very much like lions, and probably for similar reasons, demographic development, lack of habitat, also lack of political will to conserve, as the least elephants of the continent.
Though most are not aware, the United States plays an important role in the sustainability of African wildlife. From the economic benefits generated by thousands of American hunters to the regulations imposed on the importation of their trophies, the U.S. is a significant factor in African wildlife management. As such, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service was well represented at the AWCF. Though face-to-face discussions go a long way in discovering best practices in wildlife management, no trip to Africa would be complete without a little time in the field on safari.
The meeting is very important because it brings people from all over Africa, people that understand wildlife conservation at the international framework, and how do you bring those regulations from that level to the grassroots.
This forum would not be called a forum without us coming together. If we didn't agree to come, if we chose to withhold and stay back home, it wouldn't be a forum at all. And so it is actually we, the participants, that have made it possible to be called a forum. And it is actually to our own benefit.
The African Wildlife Consultative Forum provides stakeholders in African wildlife the only opportunity to come together to promote the wildlife industry, to protect hunting, and to craft a unified stance on resource management, which is a laudable achievement in and of itself. But most importantly, in a world where the best practices of conservation often take a back seat to the politically expedient, the AWCF positions Safari Club International Foundation as the voice for sustainable wildlife conservation with decision makers around the world.
It's the only forum on the continent of Africa that brings together all the people and all the parties and all the players that it does. Anybody who is a player in African wildlife is here at the AWCF.